What's up, my comic comrades? Today we're gonna take a look at one of the most popular villain teams in all of comics, the Legion of Doom. The funny thing about them is that their first appearance was not in the comic books. Legion of Doom was originally created as a counterpart of the Super Friends for the Challenge of the Super Friends Hanna-Barbera animated series. They first appeared in the episode titled Wanted the Super Friends, which first aired on September 9th of 1978. The team of villains originally consisted of Black Manta, Giganta, Toyman, Riddler, Bizarro, Scarecrow, Captain Cold, Cheetah, Solomon Grundy, Gorilla Grodd, Brainiac, Sinestro, and of course, Lex Luthor. This 16-episode series became extremely popular and launched the villain team into extreme popularity. The show introduced several of the team's staples, like their leader, which was generally Lex Luthor, and of course, their Hall of Doom, which was located in Slaughter Swamp, just outside of Gotham. Also, I can't be the only one who realized that the Hall of Doom closely resembles Darth Vader's helmet. Am I right? In any case, the Hall of Doom was able to rise in and out of the swamp and has even been seen to fly. An interesting fact is that the Challenge of the Super Friends season was originally supposed to be named Battle of the Superheroes and would feature the introduction of Captain Marvel slash Shazam to the Super Friends roster. The Legion of Doom also was not going to be called the Legion of Doom, but rather the League of Evil, which would have been led by Captain Marvel's enemy, Dr. Savannah. However, Filmation was producing the Shazam cartoon at the time and the New Adventures of Batman, which prevented the use of certain characters that ultimately led to the change of the villain team being the Legion of Doom and Shazam not being introduced in the series. The Legion of Doom wouldn't make their appearance in DC Comics proper until Extreme Justice issue 17 and 18 in June and July of 1996. In this appearance, their leader was Brainwave Jr. Other members of the team are Killer Frost, Major Force, the Madman, and a robot duplicate of Gorilla Grodd. Then believe it or not, the next major appearance in comics wouldn't happen until a decade later in 2006 in the miniseries titled Justice, which gave us amazing Alex Ross art. Now, if you know anything about Alex Ross, it is no secret that he is a massive fan of the Super Friends. So of course, in his take of the team, he brought back the classic roster consisting of Lex Luthor, Bizarro, Black Manta, Brainiac, Captain Cold, Cheetah, Giganta, Gorilla Grodd, Riddler, Scarecrow, Sinestro, Solomon Grundy, and Toyman. A lot of people. But in addition to them, we also saw other villains such as Black Adam, Clayface, Metallo, Parasite, and Poison Ivy as part of the team as well. Pretty much every villain in the DC Universe was part of the Legion of Doom in this story. It's actually a really dope story, and for those of you who don't know the premise of Justice, essentially a bunch of supervillains start having nightmares that the Earth is destroyed by a nuclear Armageddon that the Justice League couldn't prevent from happening. So the villains believe that the Justice League's overconfidence in themselves is ultimately going to lead to humanity and Earth's ruin. So all the villains decide to come together to destroy the Justice League once and for all, which in turn will let them save the world as they see fit. Hence the formation of the Legion of Doom. See, I told you it was pretty dope. Now, believe it or not, the Legion of Doom's next prominent appearance wouldn't happen until Scott Snyder and Jim Cheung's Justice League series from 2018. The first story arc of the series features none other than the Legion of Doom as the main antagonist. Essentially, what happens is Lex Luthor starts gathering a bunch of villains and tells them why he chose them to be part of his Legion, which is that he found out the real nature of men and the multiverse itself. He goes on to say the signature of men in the multiverse is going to lead towards doom. He essentially tells them that the destiny of humanity was to be the rulers of all creation and to be the most powerful race in all of the multiverse, but everything was kept away from them. But now he's been enlightened and knows that the key to doom, as he says, resides inside of an object that was gonna hit Earth soon, which would be the Totality. The Totality being a piece of source wall that is approaching the planet after the wall's destruction. We also find out that Lex Luthor picked the Legion because seven forces are needed to unlock the Totality, and the seven he picked were the perfect ones to harness its energy. Shortly after this, the Legion of Doom took Vandal Savage off the board, so to speak, because he was trying to move Earth's orbit to make sure the Totality didn't hit it. After the Legion's success, they started to fight the Justice League in order to take possession of the Totality, which was now on Earth. And this is where things get really interesting. You see, at this point, Grodd and Sinestro had already harnessed two of the seven forces, Grodd the Steel Force and Sinestro the Invisible Spectrum. So while the two of them were wreaking havoc all over Earth, Joker and Lex Luthor had secretly infiltrated inside Superman and Martian Manhunter's bodies, where also Batman and Hawkgirl were. Why, do you ask? Well, so they could enter the Totality's energy field undamaged, as Martian Manhunter and Superman are powerhouses. With Lex and the Joker shrunken down and inside of Superman and Martian Manhunter's bodies all inner space style, they were able to take control of the two heroes and started wrecking shop on all the other heroes. With the heroes down and out, the Legion of Doom took the Totality and started the process of unlocking it with the Steel Force and Invisible Spectrum. But wouldn't you know it, the heroes weren't actually down and out. Nope, surprisingly, they were able to counter Umbrax's attack. Umbrax is a dark emotional entity who is a timeless primordial force of the cosmos connected to and acting at the center of the invisible spectrum. And the League did this thanks to Flash accessing the Still Force. Also by this time, Hawkgirl is now powered by the totality, allowing her to attack Lex Luthor and bring the object to the Hall of Justice, before Luthor could do whatever he wanted with it inside of the Hall of Doom. Essentially, the Legion's first battle was lost, but as they say, the war was far from over. At this point, Lex Luthor was a little desperate and decided to ask for the help of the Batman Who Laughs, who he had as a prisoner. And we all know where that led us, to DC's Death Metal. If you know nothing about Death Metal, you could check out the videos on that right here. And that pretty much brings us up to date as far as the Legion of Doom in the DC Universe proper comic books. And as far as powers and abilities, I mean, you name it, they got it, as the Legion of Doom has consisted of basically every major villain in the DC Universe. They're essentially the Justice League of villains, with villains such as Lex Luthor, Grodd, Sinestro, Captain Cold, Riddler, Scarecrow, Solomon Grundy, the list goes on and on. Much like how every major hero in the DC Universe has been part of the Justice League at one point or another. Anyway, that brings us to reading recommendations. To learn more about the Legion of Doom, check out Extreme Justice issue 17 and 18, the Alex Ross Justice miniseries, and of course, the 2018 Justice League title. Also, you definitely want to watch the 1978 Challenge of the Super Friends series, along with the Justice League Unlimited animated series, which is one of my favorites of all time, and the Young Justice series. That should be enough to get you all started. First up for the week of February 23rd, we have Ghost Rider issue 1. This looks like a brand new take on Johnny Blaze and the Spirit of Vengeance by writer Benjamin Percy and artist Corey Smith. And with Marvel Comics on a solid run, this is definitely worth checking out. Next up, we have Gunslinger Spawn issue 5. A new and more powerful clown has returned with a double dose of evil, as he has found a way to split himself into two. Now both the clown and the Violator can attack the Gunslinger at the same time. Third on the list, we have Deathstroke Inc. issue 6. The reign of the King of Deathstroke begins. After the shocking truth about trust is revealed, Deathstroke finds himself the leader of a new army. Does he use that army for good or evil? Next up, we have Dark Ages issue 5. Spider-Man joins Dr. Doom, the X-Men, the Inhumans, the Avengers, and what's left of the Fantastic Four on a rescue mission across a continent ruled by a madman. But they could be too late. The dictator of Europe has heroes and villains by his side, and the unthinkable is now in motion. Apocalypse could tear the world apart. And lastly, we have Teen Titans Academy issue 12. As their lives are literally tumbling down around them, the Titans must contend with the betrayal of their most troubled student who has just unmasked themselves as Red X. Plus, a familiar face from Teen Titans past is out for revenge on Nightwing. In the end, what's going to be left of Teen Titans Academy? And that's going to bring today's episode to a close, but if you like today's video, check out this one to my left, your right, and if you like all of our content, subscribe, like, and comment. It always helps the channel grow. But other than that, I'll see you guys next time when I talk about all things comics.